وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ
وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to Quran Circle 2. I'm Arkam Rashid, your host. In this episode, we will recite all of Surah Fatir, and the theme that we chose is who are the people of knowledge. So let's start off as usual by introducing and welcoming our guest for today. On my right hand side, I have Sheikh Ibrahim Zidane. Assalamu alaikum and welcome to the show.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi.
Sheikh, if you can give us the definition to what Fatir means.
Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam wa rasulullah wa ba'd. The word Fatir is one of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that comes with the transition of the Creator. The creator of the heavens and the earth and the creator of all things. But it really has more specific, delicate meaning to it, and he's the one that initiated everything. Mm. So he's the creator, but he's the one that initiated and everything, and even Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he mentioned this, that he didn't know exactly what was the word Fatir till he heard one of the Bedouins, two Bedouins in dispute, one is saying to the other with regards to Awal, I the one that initiated it, and he used the same word. So it's the initiator, the one that created everything from no previous model, basically.
Okay, thank you very much for that, Sheikh. That wonderful introduction there to the title of the surah. So now we know what we're going to be reading about, inshallah. Now I'm going to introduce our reciters for today. On my right-hand side, I have Qari Aymin Abdul Mun'im. Assalamu alaikum and welcome to the show.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome.
And next to him, we have Qari Abdul Rahman Sa'id. Assalamu alaikum and welcome to the show.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
So starting us off today with his beautiful recitation is Qari Ayman. So go ahead and open to the first verse of Surah Fatir and follow along and enjoy.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. الحمد لله فاطر السماوات والأرض جاعل الملائكة رسلا أولي أجنحة مثنى وثلاث ورباع جاعل الملائكة رسلا أولي أجنحة مثنى وثلاث ورباع يزيد في الخلق ما يشاء إن الله على كل شيء قدير ما يفتح الله للناس من رحمة فلا ممسك لها وما يمسك فلا مرسل له من بعده وهو العزيز الحكيم يا أيها الناس اذكروا نعمة الله عليكم هل من خالق غير الله يرزقكم من السماء والأرض لا إله إلا هو فأنى تؤفكون وإن يكذبوك فقد كذبت رسل من قبلك وإلى الله ترجع الأمور يا أيها الناس إن وعد الله حق فلا تغرنكم الحياة الدنيا ولا يغرنكم بالله الغرور إن الشيطان لكم عدو فاتخذوه عدوا إنما يدعو حزبه ليكونوا من أصحاب السعير الذين كفروا لهم عذاب شديد والذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات لهم مغفرة وأجر كبير أفمن زين له سوء عمله فرآه حسنا فإن الله يضل من يشاء ويهدي من يشاء فلا تذهب نفسك عليهم حسرات إن الله عليم بما يصنعون والله الذي أرسل الرياح فتثير سحابا فسقناه إلى بلد ميت فأحيينا به الأرض بعد موتها كذلك النشور من كان يريد العزة فلله العزة جميعا إليه يصعد الكلم الطيب والعمل الصالح يرفعه والذين يمكرون السيئات لهم عذاب شديد ومكر أولئك هو يبور والله خلقكم من تراب ثم من نطفة ثم جعلكم أزواجا وما تحمل من أنثى ولا تضع إلا بعلمه وما يعمر من معمر ولا ينقص من عمره إلا في كتاب إن ذلك على الله يسير وما يستوي البحران هذا عذب فرات سائغ شرابه وهذا ملح أجاج ومن كل تأكلون لحما طريا وتستخرجون حلية تلبسونها وترى الفلك فيه مواخر لتبتغوا من فضله ولعلكم تشكرون يولج الليل في النهار ويولج النهار في الليل وسخر الشمس والقمر كل يجري لأجل مسمى ذلكم الله ربكم له الملك والذين تدعون من دونه ما يملكون من قطمير والذين تدعون من دونه ما يملكون من قطمير إن تدعوهم لا يسمعوا دعاءكم ولو سمعوا ما استجابوا لكم ويوم القيامة يكفرون بشرككم ولا ينبئك مثل خبير ولا ينبئك مثل خبير يا أيها الناس أنتم الفقراء إلى الله يا الفقراء إلى الله والله هو الغني الحميد إن يشأ يذهبكم ويأتي بخلق جديد وما ذلك على الله بعزيز ولا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى وإن تدع مثقلة إلى حملها لا يحمل منه شيء ولو كان ذا قربى إنما تنذر الذين يخشون ربهم بالغيب وأقاموا الصلاة ومن تزكى فإنما يتزكى لنفسه وإلى الله المصير وما يستوي الأعمى والبصير ولا الظلمات ولا النور ولا الظل ولا الحرور وما يستوي الأحياء ولا الأموات إن الله يسمع من يشاء وما أنت بمسمع من في القبور إن أنت إلا نذير إنا أرسلناك بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا وإن من أمة إلا خلا فيها نذير يكذبوك فقد كذب الذين من قبلهم جاءتهم رسلهم بالبينات وبالزبر وبالكتاب المنير ثم أخذت الذين كفروا فكيف كان نكير
جزاكم الله خير Thank you very much Qari Amin that was beautiful Thank you Sheikh as you explained in the beginning of the show that Fatir is to initiate or to create something from nothing so the surah starts off with Alhamdulillah all praises to Allah Fatir as-samawati wal-ard the creator of the heavens and the earth I want to get into the second verse, which is مَا يَفْتَحِ اللَّهُ لِلنَّاسِ مِنْ رَحْمَةٍ فَلَا مُمْسِكَ لَهَا وَمَا يُمْسِكَ فَلَا مُرْسِلَ لَهُ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ Can you explain that to us?
نعم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, since He's the creator of the heavens and the earth, and He's the creator of the angels and all that exists, He's also the one that bestows His mercy to whomsoever He wills, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ayah says, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens matters of mercy, nobody is able to withhold it. And if it's withheld, nobody can let it go whatsoever and open it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the owner of things. And the sense that a person would reflect upon when you listen to the verse, it's such a beautiful thing that when the rahmah, when the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes, it comes in abundance. And this is something that the best of all things is when people would receive the message of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is this ilm. And that's why when we talk about knowledge and the people of knowledge, this is really the subject of mercy. This is a mercy that is in this life and in the hereafter. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and also the physical aspects of the rahmah that we see in our lives and even in the actions of the animals and everything. And this is just one part out of 99, out of 100 parts of mercy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created in His creation. And 99 will be kept in the Day of Judgment only for the believers. And if it was for the human beings, they are the ones that has the way to dispose the mercy or not, they will become so greedy. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the owner of this mercy. That's why, therefore, I mean, there's the actions that comes with this, is that people need to seek that from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and witness it and humble themselves to the mercy of Allah.
Okay. Sheikh, the few verses that follow afterwards are quite clear. وَإِنْ يُكَذِّبُكَ فَقَدْ كُذِّبَتْ رُسُلٌ مِّن قَبْلِكَ. If we go down to verse number 8, however, it gets a little bit confusing, or it can have some tafsir to it. Can you give us the tafsir for that verse 8, inshallah?
Naam. Verse number 8, and again, as we see, the verses, one is leading to the other.
Yes.
And that's why the context is important, that we get certain meanings in our hearts when we're reciting the Quran and reflecting over the meanings of it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of all things. He's the bestower of His mercy subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the verses talked about the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the truth, so don't be deceived. And as a result of that, people will be into two groups, the believers and the disbelievers, and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised the believers and what also the disbelievers are promised from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the ayah talks about what makes many people deceive in this life, deceive themselves and fall into the hellfire, is that their evil actions will be adorned for them. فَمَنْ زُيِّنَ لَهُ سُوءُ عَمَلِي. That his actions are evil, and the person would see it as a good thing.
Is this in this world or in the year after?
This is in this world, that people would see their evil actions as good, and it would lead them to وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ the hellfire. And that's why the deviation and guidance is all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ayah is comforting the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that his message is to convey it to the people. His job is to convey the message to the people. And the Prophet ﷺ, it hurted him so much that people would deviate after seeing the truth. Be amazed, people would get to see the truth and they know that it's the truth and they would still deviate away from the truth. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is comforting the Prophet ﷺ that these people, the matter has been adorned for them. They see the evil and it's evil, but they see it as a good thing.
But the verb that's used here is zuyyina.
No.
It has been adorned. Who's right. The one that has adorned this?
This is something that as a punishment for them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will adorn for them the evil, or the shaitan would adorn for them the evil. But because they listen to the shaitan and they out of stubbornness and arrogance, they refuse the truth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will change their hearts and the hearts become flipped. So they would see the evil good and the good evil. And this is why it says, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يُضِلُّ مَن يَشَاءُ وَيَهْدِي مَن يَشَاءُ. Because indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deviates whoever He wills and He guides whoever He wills, but He's the most just subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as other verses in the Quran explains this meaning, فَلَمَّا زَاغُوا أَزَاغَ اللَّهُ قُلُوبَهُمْ. When they deviated, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deviated the hearts. So the point here to comfort the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَلَا تَذْهَبِ نَفْسُكَ عَلَيْهِمْ حَسَرَةً. Do not make yourself go after them in so much regret and loss and sadness, right? And the beautiful expression is amazing. Do not go to the end level or to the utmost level of hasra or regret as a result of them refusing the truth, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed is all knower of what they do, and He's the one that guides and He's the one that also lead astray.
That verse reminds me a little bit of the verse from Surah Al-Baqarah. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ لَا تُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ قَالُوا إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ مُصْلِحُونَ. That when it is said to them that don't cause destruction on earth, they say, you know, we are nothing but the ones that are bringing about good on earth.
Right.
So it kind of reminded me of that verse.
And that's related to the subject of knowledge, because this is the most fearful thing that should be present in the hearts of the believers. That a person should have the fear of Allah, that he might be seeing things not in the right way.
Yeah.
And that's why we need to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guidance And the way for us to see what is right and what is wrong is knowledge, the knowledge of the deen of Islam. And with the knowledge is the taqwa, the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that we're not deceived or deviated as these people are deviated.
Okay, and if we look in verse number 10, Shaykh, it says, من كان يريد العزة فلله العزة جميعا. What I want to know is, what is the next part of it? It says, إليه يصعد الكلم الطيب والعمل الصالح. What does this mean?
No. First of all, the izzah, the honor and dignity and power, this is all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you seek that in this life, seek it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He's the owner of all things. Don't seek it from human beings. And then the ayah says that to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes up the pure speech and the pure and the righteous actions. So that means this is one of the evidences that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the Most High. He's over His creation, subhanahu wa ta'ala, over His throne, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing is the like of Him. And deeds are presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this deeds being presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is on daily basis. Every day, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, two angels, they stay with the person from Fajr time to Asr, and two angels with each person from Asr to Fajr. The angels of the day and the angels of the night, and they take turns and they take shifts and they go up. And they present things to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Things are presented also on Thursdays. And that's why the Prophet ﷺ used to fast Mondays and Thursdays. And things are presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on a yearly basis, like in the month of Sha'ban, as the Prophet ﷺ also said. So the deeds are being presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. And this is by the mercy and the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for people to witness what are they letting their deeds to go up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what kind of deeds are they? What are the deeds that are being presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from us? Are they deeds that we'll be proud of? Something that if we truly love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, are we presenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the good actions or the evil actions and disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And that's why those who plot evil, and that's why yamkurun, not those who would just commit open evil, those who would plot and they sneakily do things, this is evil things, they have a severe punishment, and they thought that they can deceive Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No, everything is being presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and their makr and their deception will ruin them, will be ruined, and it will ruin them, and it will go around them and destroy them. So this is again for those who would fall into the sins and these evil sins to have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's with the effect of the tawheed, the oneness of worship of Allah, and the effect of ilm. This is knowledge. This is a treasure for the believers when they read it. Because without it, people are astray. They don't know what's going on beyond what they see with their own eyes. So the ghaib or the unseen is an amazing thing. Things are happening in front of our eyes, but we don't see it because it's unseen to us.
Okay, Sheikh. Sheikh, I want to move on to verse number 15 to 18, but we'll have one of the reciters recite it. If Qari Abdurrahman, if you can recite for us from Ya Ayyuhan Nasu Antum Al Fuqara until Wa Ila Allahi Al Masir, inshallah.
A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitanir Rajeem. Ya Ayyuhan Nasu Antum Al Fuqara Ila Allahi Wallahu Huwa Al Ghaniyul Hamid. إن يشأ يذهبكم ويأتي بخلق جديد وما ذلك على الله بعزيز ولا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى وإن تدع مثقلة إلى حملها لا يحمل منه شيء ولو كان ذا قربى إنما تنذر الذين يخشون ربهم بالغيب وأقاموا الصلاة ومن تزكى فإنما يتزكى لنفسه وإلى الله المصير.
Thank you very much, Qari Abdurrahman. Thank you. Sheikh, if we can get a brief tafsir of these verses, specifically the last verse that was recited.
The surah is talking about the kufr and iman and disbelief and belief and the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the ayat of Allah, so that it leads us to this call, for example, O mankind, you are the ones fuqara, you are in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most rich and the most praiseworthy. So humble yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and worship Him alone and be obedient to Him. If He will subhanahu wa ta'ala, He can remove you away, take you away, destroy all of us. We have no power whatsoever. Just for one order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can destroy all those who are on the earth. And He would replace the people with another creation. And this is not something difficult for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing our hearts. And we need to make sure that these types of meanings are present in our heart. That we are in need of the religion. We are in need to be steadfast. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not need us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in no need whatsoever of His creation. But then the next ayah shows the justice of Allah. Even though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is capable of wiping away or out all of His creation, but this is not what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do. Instead, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most just. No one would bear the sin of another. Everything is with very precise measure. And this life of the human beings, everything is recorded. Everything is, you know, either they would see the rewards or the punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And no one would bear the sin of the other, right? Even from a mother to a son or vice versa, right? Even if it's the closest person to you, the ones that loved you so much in this life, they would run away from you in the day of judgment. Each person will come alone in the day of judgment. Nobody will defend another. Everybody will come with their own actions. And that's why those who would benefit from the warning from these verses, those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bil ghayb. By the way, يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ. It will be repeated when it talked about the people of knowledge. Those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the unseen and they establish the salah, they are the ones that the warnings or these warnings would affect them and would benefit them. And these are the ones that have a pure soul. وَمَنْ تَزَكَّ فَإِنَّمَا يَتَزَكَّ نَفْسِهِ. Whoever purify his soul, himself, he's doing that for his own self, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most rich and everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's basically giving us the keys and the means to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to be saved in the day of judgment from going after one another's actions and good deeds, to have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to establish the salah, to purify ourselves by the fear of Allah and establishing the salah, and to have the belief that everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
All right, thank you very much for that, Sheikh. Dear viewers, we're going to go for a short break, and as soon as we come back, we will finish with the recitation of Surah Fatir, so stay tuned.
وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ.
Welcome back to Quran Circle 2. Now, before we went for that short break, we were reciting Surah Fatir, and we spoke about how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not in need of any of us, and we are all in need of Him. So now we will continue with the recitation of Surah Fatir. So go ahead, open your mushafs, and enjoy a recitation from Qari Abdurrahman Sa'id.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajeem. ألم تر أن الله أنزل من السماء ماء فأخرجنا به ثمرات مختلفا ألوانها ومن الجبال جدد بيض وحمر مختلف ألوانها وغرابيب سود ومن الناس والدواب والأنعام مختلف ألوانه كذلك إنما يخشى الله من عباده العلماء إن الله عزيز غفور إن الذين يتلون كتاب الله وأقاموا الصلاة وأنفقوا مما رزقناهم سرا وعلانية يرجون تجارة لن تبور ليوفيهم أجورهم ويزيدهم من فضله إنه غفور شكور والذي أوحينا إليك من الكتاب هو الحق مصدقا لما بين يديه إن الله بعباده لخبير بصير ثم أورثنا الكتاب الذين اصطفينا من عبادنا فمنهم ظالم لنفسه ومنهم مقتصد ومنهم سابق بالخيرات بإذن الله ذلك هو الفضل الكبير جنات عدن يدخلونها يحلون فيها من أساور من ذهب ولؤلؤا ولباسهم فيها حرير وقالوا الحمد لله الذي أذهب عنا الحزن إن ربنا لغفور شكور الذي أحلنا دار المقامة من فضله لا يمسنا فيها نصب ولا يمسنا فيها لغوب والذين كفروا لهم نار جهنم لا يقضى عليهم فيموتوا ولا يخفف عنهم من عذابها كذلك نجزي كل كفور وهم يصطرخون فيها ربنا أخرجنا نعمل صالحا غير الذي كنا نعمل أولم نعمركم ما يتذكر فيه من تذكر وجاءكم النذير فذوقوا فما للظالمين من نصير إن الله عالم غيب السماوات والأرض إنه عليم بذات الصدور هو الذي جعلكم خلائف في الأرض فمن كفر فعليه كفره ولا يزيد الكافرين كفرهم عند ربهم إلا مقتا ولا يزيد الكافرين كفرهم إلا خسارا قل أرأيتم شركاءكم الذين تدعون من دون الله أروني ماذا خلقوا من الأرض أم لهم شرك في السماوات أم آتيناهم كتابا فهم على بينة منه بل إن يعد الظالمون بعضهم بعضا إلا غرورا إن الله يمسك السماوات والأرض أن تزولا ولئن زالتا إن أمسكهما من أحد من بعده ولئن زالتا إن أمسكهما من أحد من بعده إنه كان حليما غفورا وأقسموا بالله جهد أيمانهم لئن جاءهم نذير ليكونن أهدى من إحدى الأمم فلما جاءهم نذير ما زادهم إلا نفورا استكبارا في الأرض ومكر السيء ولا يحيق المكر السيء إلا بأهله فهل ينظرون إلا سنة الأولين فلن تجد لسنة الله تبديلا ولن تجد لسنة الله تحويلا أولم يسيروا في الأرض فينظروا كيف كان عاقبة الذين من قبلهم وكانوا أشد منهم قوة وما كان الله ليعجزه من شيء في السماوات ولا في الأرض إنه كان عليما قديرا ولو يؤاخذ الله الناس بما كسبوا ما ترك على ظهرها من دابة ما ترك على ظهرها من دابة ولكن يؤخرهم إلى أجل مسمى فإذا جاء أجلهم فإن الله كان بعباده بصيرا.
جزاكم الله خير. Thank you very much, قاري عبد الرحمن.
Thanks.
Thank you. شيخ, if we can start towards the beginning of his recitation, in the verse he mentioned right here, verse number 28. Now, our theme for today actually is around this topic. So if we can first get a tafsir of verse 28 and 29, and then we can speak about who these people are, who are these ulama.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the surah is reminding us with the different signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from His creation, for people to reflect upon these signs. And this is something that is so much in the Quran, as we see, to lead people to one thing, and that is worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and establish all of these different acts of worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a result of what you've heard of these great signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the only ones that would benefit from it and have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and accordingly would worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the people of knowledge. Mm-hmm. And that's why with all of the different creation of Allah, إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. And innama in Arabic gives the meanings of something so exclusive that the only ones that would fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the people of knowledge. A person might say, but if a person is not a scholar in the deen of Islam, he doesn't fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a good believer. No, it doesn't say that. It means that you have to have the knowledge to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also it says that if a person is supposed to be a person of knowledge but he doesn't fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is not a person of knowledge. So for a person to have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has to have knowledge, and for the person of knowledge, he has to have fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why Abdullah ibn Mubarak rahimahullah, he said, إِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ الْخَشْيَةِ. He said, indeed the ilm or the knowledge is nothing but the fear of Allah, and that's the fruits of it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Almighty and He is the most forgiver. And then it praises those people of knowledge. They are the ones that recite the book of Allah. And by the way, يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ. People always think of the recitation of the Quran. This is one of the meanings. But the other meanings is those who follow the book of Allah. So يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ, it has two meanings. Those who follow the book of Allah and those who recite the book of Allah. To follow, of course, the book of Allah. And they establish the salats mentioned again. They spend from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided for them. This is knowledge. People do not see that in their lives, that whatever they have of wealth, they think it's their wealth. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided that for them. So spend a portion of it secretly and openly. And why is that? يَرْجُونَ تِجَارَةً لَنْ تَبُورَ. They are hoping, seeking a trade that would never be in loss whatsoever. This is the trade with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we heard about that in Surah At-Tawbah and others. So this is from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with matters of knowledge to link all of this with the signs of Allah and the actions of the people of the knowledge and the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the true knowledge that we need to seek.
Okay, and I mean our theme is based off of this ayah, or this verse, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that verily true fear of Allah comes from those who are ulama, those of knowledge. What I want to do is, you give us a wonderful tafsir of the verses. I want to know who exactly are these ulama, and how can a regular person become from amongst these ulama?
Yeah. Who are the ulama? They are the ones that the characteristics of them are mentioned in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. Prophet ﷺ, for example, he said, "Al-ulama warathatul anbiya." The ulama are the inheritors of the prophets. So the alim is the one that would remind you of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He has the knowledge of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he has this knowledge, plus his actions. He would remind the people of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with his speech, with his actions, with the way he conduct things, right? And if that's why, if a alim seen to be committing a sin openly in front of the people, or this is not his life or whatever, he is definitely not an alim, because he's supposed to remind the people of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they are the best among the people that would apply these characteristics of the believers, as it's mentioned in the Quran, even in the khashya, because the word innama yakhsha Allah, those who fear Allah, we know that in the Arabic language there is the word al khawf, the fear, and al khashya also means fear. But what's the difference between both? Al khashya is khawfun bi'ilm, as the ulama they say, is to fear Allah with knowledge. Because if a person fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala but without knowledge, he can ruin himself basically.
So that by comes worshiping under khawf.
Right, that comes under the khawf. But the khashya is fear with knowledge. Now I might give an example of somebody is running away from a lion, for example. Yeah. He's running without no knowledge, he can be just a very easy prey for the for the lion. But if someone knows his direction, he goes to a fortified place and he hides himself, his heart is settled, he's not panicking, because he's acting based on knowledge. And of course, when it comes to the fear of Allah, we flee from the punishment of Allah to the mercy of Allah by applying what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. Many people on the face of earth, they claim to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they innovate in the deen. They worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They do evil things, all with the intention that they fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why it needs the knowledge. And the people of knowledge are supposed to be the most who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and even stay away sometimes from some of the halal out of the fear that they would fall into something haram.
Okay, thank you very much for that. Sheikh, now I want to move on to another category of people that's mentioned, but we can get one of the reciters to recite verse number 31 and 32. Inshallah, if Qari Ayman, you can recite from وَالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا until ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَضْلُ الْكَبِيرُ.
والذي أوحينا إليك من الكتاب هو الحق مصدقا لما بين يديه إن الله بعباده لخبير بصير ثم أورثنا الكتاب الذين اصطفينا من عبادنا فمنهم ظالم لنفسه ومنهم مقتصد ومنهم سابق بالخيرات بإذن الله ذلك هو الفضل الكبير.
جزاك الله خير. Thank you very much. Sheikh, if in the second verse that he recited, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala says, فَمِنْهُمْ ظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِهِ وَمِنْهُمْ مُقْتَصِدٌ وَمِنْهُمْ سَابِقٌ بِالْخَيْرَاتِ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. Who are these three categories of people?
These are the three categories of the believers. And not the disbelievers and the believers. This is all among the ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, those who inherited the book after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is the inheritance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He passed on this knowledge the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and this book that is inherited to those who came after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose from among his slaves, those who believe in the Prophet ﷺ and follow him. Among them are those who transgress upon them their own selves. They wrong their own selves by committing sins. And among them, the second category, muqtasid. And muqtasid is the one that do the obligations and stay away from haram. And as-sabiq bil khayrat, the one that is in haste in doing good deeds, the one that does not just do the obligations and stay away from haram, but he do the option acts of worship and elevate himself in the good deeds and so on. And all of that is by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the great bounty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that even the wrongdoers, is not to belittle the wrongdoing, but the wrongdoers, if they are still within the fold of Islam, they still receive some of the mercy of Allah. They need to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of course, because they subject themselves to the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if they die in the state of Islam, eventually they will enter Jannah even if they are punished in the hereafter. That's why the next ayah says Jannatu Adn yadkhulunaha, they would enter the Jannat of Adn and they would be adorned in it and so on and so forth. So it talks about the believers, and it talks about a very significant thing here is ثم أورثنا الكتاب. That means we let the book be inherited. When we compare this ummah to the nations before, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he talked about Bani Israel, they inherited the book from Musa alayhi salam, but they did not bear this amana and this trust. They betrayed this trust. فَخَلَفَ مِن بَعْدِهِمْ خَلْفٌ وَرِثُوا الْكِتَابِ. Came from generation after them, those who inherited the book, يَأْخُذُونَ عَرَضَ هَذَا الْأَدْنَى, in the verse in Surah Al-A'raf. They took the book, inherited the book, and sometimes, most of the time, when you inherit something, you don't really feel the preciousness of it. Usually the one that worked hard for his money, right, if he inherits the money to his son doesn't care, so he spends it lavishly. So they inherited the book and they said, Allah would forgive us. And they did not apply the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if matters of the dunya comes to them, they would take that and they would not choose the book of Allah. But for this ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they inherited the book, yes, the wahi from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there are always going to be these three categories among the ummah. And the book of Allah will still be saved, and also the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's by the fadl and the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that should make the ummah repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a way of being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to stay away from what the nations before or the people of the book did to their books and to their messengers.
Okay, thank you very much for that, Sheikh. Moving on, it speaks about, I mean, the verse that you mentioned, Jannatu Adn, it talks about the Jannah. And then it says, وَقَالَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي أَذْهَبَ عَنَّ الْحَزَنِ. I want to know what this hazan is. After that, then it speaks about the people of Jahannam a little bit. And it says, وَهُمْ يَصْطَرِخُونَ فِيهَا رَبَّنَا أَخْرِجْنَا نَعْمَلْ صَالِحًا غَيْرَ الَّذِي كُنَّا نَعْمَلْ أَوَلَمْ نُعَمِّرْكُمْ مَا يَتَذَكَّرُ فِيهِ مَنْ تَذَكَّرَ وَجَاءَكُمُ النَّذِيرُ. If you can give us some of the tafsir for these verses.
As we see, the verses talks about first the people, the believers, and they would enter the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they have all kinds of adornments in there. And some of the things they would say, and that shows their joy in Jannah, that they would praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that pushed away from them al-hazan, the tightness, the difficulty, the sadness, right? And they would say, Inna Rabbana, our Lord is the most forgiver, the most grateful. And this is how they enter Jannah. They enter Jannah not by their deeds and because they were so great people. It's by the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He forgave their sins. And he's Shakur subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Shakur means grateful, that he accepted these simple deeds that he ordered them to do. And he gave them this great reward, which is nothing really compared to the deeds. The deeds are very simple and small. And the reward is tremendous from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one that made them attend and be admitted to the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the bounty of Allah. No fatigue afflict them, no tiredness, nothing whatsoever of bad would afflict them whatsoever in Jannah, everlasting joy for them. And the opposite of that is the everlasting and the worst misery whatsoever for those who disbelieve. They would have the hellfire, they would not die in there, the punishment would not be lessened for them, they would not have any relief whatsoever. And this is by the justice of Allah, كَذَلِكَ نَجِزِي كُلَّ كَفُورٍ. This is how we recompensed every kafur. It's because, and mention here the characteristics. Yeah. It's not because of them as a person, it's because of their actions, because of their disbelief. Yeah. And kafur meaning those who were ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by hiding the truth, by not following the truth. Then it shows some of their affairs in the hellfire. They scream, وَهُمْ يَصْطَرِخُونَ فِيهَا. they scream so loud, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best how loud that is, and they would ask their Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to get them out to do what? نعمل صالحا غير الذي كنا نعمل. They would ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if he can get them out of the fire to do righteous good deeds different than what they used to do. So it's a great reminder that we are still alive, alhamdulillah, and that's the time where we do the righteous good deeds so that we don't fall into this regret of these people. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَوَلَمْ نُعَمِّرْكُمْ مَا يَتَذَكَّرُ فِيهِ مَنْ تَذَكَّرُ. Didn't we give you enough life in this life for you to remember, and for those who want to remember, to remember, and the warner came to you. What did the ulama said? Here it means you have reached 40 years old, you have reached 60 years, right? That means the matter has been established on you. You lived on the earth well enough, long enough, to know what is right and what is wrong, and the warner came to you. Then as a result, nobody, of course, will come out of the hellfire if they're disbelievers and they're there forever. Taste, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَذُوقُوا فَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ نَصِيرٍ. The dhalimeen, the wrongdoers, would never get any helper or any support whatsoever, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the all-knower of all things. And because of their actions, because of their being ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will punish them such a severe and everlasting punishment.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all, Amen. Inshallah, and make us amongst the sabiqun bil khayrat bi idhnillah. Sheikh, I want to thank you. That brings us to the end of this episode. Once again, we look forward to you joining us, or for you to join us on many more episodes, inshallah. And I want to thank both of you, Qari Ayman and Qari Abdurrahman, for your wonderful recitations. We always enjoy your recitations, and we look forward on having you on many more episodes to the end, inshallah. Dear viewers, I hope you guys enjoyed today's episode. Don't forget to join us again on Quran Circle 2. And until then, may God bless us all. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.